The mascot here at the Winter Universiade is Ulaika. That a dog which has been seen everywhere. And we're here now for the fourth day of competition at the biathlon at the Winter Universiade in Krasnoyarsk. Already we've had the individual, the sprint and the pursuit races. They've been run and basically won by teams from the host nation. But they will not win all the medals today because each country is limited to one team. But the team from Norway, Russian Federation, Czech Republic, Poland, also got Canada, Slovakia, Belarus, France and Switzerland, Japan and the Republic of Moldova. Because this is the single mixed relay today on day four of competition. The biathlon venue really does look superb for this fourth day of racing. And watching here and hearing the reactions about the facility suggests you'll be seeing many more major events here in Krasnoyarsk. There was just a light falling of snow throughout the evening, but you wouldn't notice it here. Again, the weather is fine, beautiful blue sky. The females will begin this race. Valeria Vasnetsova will lead off for the Russian team, the favourites, of course. And getting so much assistance from this very vocal crowd. Blue sky, slightly overcast with a few clouds there, but in general, we've had superb conditions. They all start together. It really is first across the line. Just a slight imbalance at the start there from Vasnetsova as she tried to get the Russians away. It just held her back a little bit. Leading off for the Czech Republic is Natalie Zhirkova. For Poland there and on the right in lane number three, or bib number three, it's Magda Piksura. So those were the front three as they left the start here in this first ever single mixed relay to be held at a Winter Universiade. Wonderful view as they come into this picture for the first time en masse. And you can see they're close together. There is a climb a little bit later on. In fact, they're not far away from it now, where they rise just 20 metres or so, but it is a great one to get underway early on because it will soon sort out who are the contenders when it comes to the climbs later on. And looking very comfortable is Natalie Zhirkova, number two. So the Czech Republic wearing number two, the Russian Federation number one. So Russia from the Czech Republic, one and two coming into the shooting range. You see there, the breeze has not changed direction for the entire week it's been at southwesterly. And as Coach Alexander Selifanov was just chatting this morning, saying it really is a little bit of luck. Sometimes you get to the range and the wind will drop for you, which is good. Otherwise, they just have to work out and account for the wind that is there. First time on the range in this single mixed relay. Five targets. Five rounds in the magazine. They carry three spears. So if they miss, they can use those spears. If they use up all those spears, then they are into the 75-meter penalty loop. And already we see one of the athletes away was that from Switzerland. French combination is Marine Chalamel and Félix Côté-Puinel. It's Djurkova. Next through comes Kittelsen of Norway, who really has been one of the best shooters among the females. Not quite so quick around the course. France with Chalamel. The French are leading at this first stage. A long way to go in this race. And lots of visits to the range, lots of bullets to be fired. Chalamel attends the University of Grenoble. And here is Kittelsen. So we have France, Czech Republic, and Norway. Interesting situation has already developed in the single mixed relay. The women have coming up to complete their second lap. And it's Chalamel of France. Wind is just slightly different to when we last saw it, and now it picks up again. So the shooters have to take into account what they see before them. It might be different to what they encountered first time up. So Chalamel of France leads the shooters into the range for the second time. First standing shoot. This is where things could change. Czech Republic. That's Djurkova shooting very quickly. Gets a miss here, but she's only got one more. No, another miss for the Czech Republic's Natalia Djurkova. So they have the three spare rounds. Oh, and Chalamel can't find the target either. Everyone else falls around her, but now Djurkova takes off. The Russian, Vasnetsova, clear now. And still the Frenchwoman, who went in with the lead, has missed with all three spares, and so she will go into that penalty loop area and complete it three times, 75 metres. And it's David Tollard, who was seventh in the sprint and 10th in the pursuit. The gap they have is 10 seconds back to Dedukhin of the Russian Federation. They're the first two. France now, what a big letdown for Chalamel, having led them into the first shoot with about a 6 or 7 second advantage. She's now 45 seconds down at the exchange. The two together, Russia and the Czech Republic. At the moment, they're making this a two-team race. The Russian gets a huge roar, Alexander Dedukhin. He was fourth in the individual, so he has shot quite well. Hasn't been among the medals for this Russian team, which has won every medal bar one. Now he comes in prone shoot. Tollard. Here's Alexander Selifanov. And as he said beforehand, there's a bit of luck with the breeze. And even there you notice, just watch the wind indicators, how much they change around, so the shooters have to contend with that. Dedukhin shooting very quickly with one miss. Gets it now, so he has the advantage. Oh, the Norwegian Uldal has not shot well at all. Trying quickly, trying to stay in the race. But he will be visiting the penalty range. So it is still the Russian Federation and the Czech Republic, 1 and 2. They're really just sorting themselves out here. Big advantage over the rest, as the shooters from the other teams could not match it. Strongly away is Yannick, in third place, Poland. This is, if you're not into biathlon, this is the single mixed relay, which is a new event. It's being held at the World Championships for the first time this week. And it's here at the Winter Universiade in Krasnoyarsk, Siberia, as we wait for the second exchange. The women led off, so teams of two, one man, one woman. The women lead off and do one lap and shoot in the prone position. They do a second lap and shoot in the standing position, and then they make the exchange to the men, who do the same. The Dukan just seems to be stretching away. We'll get a better indication shortly when we see David Tolar from the Czech Republic come in, but he's not in view yet. He's got a lot of time in which to be accurate here. He doesn't need to shoot quickly. Oh, wow, he shot so quickly. Now he has to use each of his spears. Oh, that's one penalty lap he needs to do. That's another. Well, he's giving the check an opportunity here to close this gap. So two penalty laps for Dedukin. That'll eat into that lead he had. David Tolar taking a long time to steady. Wow, you could sense that the rifle was not absolutely still. And he's had another miss. In the meantime, Dedukin has probably just about exited the penalty loop. There he goes now. So it wasn't as costly as what he might have thought, because it appears too as though Tolar had another miss there and will be into the penalty loop. Just see him to the left. So the gap could have closed, but the Czech Republic shooter could not close that gap enough. We'll have the exchange now, second exchange, male onto female. And it's the Russians just in front. So Vasnetsova of Russia, she is in front. And she'll be well aware that Shalamal skied exceptionally well in the opening two legs. Both get the harnesses off together, both on the mat together. Those conditions might be a bit difficult down here. You see the wind indicators look slightly different in both lanes. And we see the red flashes go up far too often. Oh, another miss for Vasnetsova into her second spare round. Needs to nail these two. She's got one of them. This one to avoid going into the penalty loop. Oh, she misses, so she does visit the penalty loop. And Chalamel is also away. Now, what happened with Chalamel? She's following Vasnetsova into the penalty loop. Now, a big change in this race, the single mixed relay on day four of competition. Poland in front, the Czech Republic second. In third place, the Russian Federation. But only 10 seconds from first to third, and then only another couple of seconds back to Chalamel of France. Up the climb they come. Vasnetsova has battled back well after a poor fifth shoot. She was 9 seconds behind Pixura of Poland, but she has spurred her way forward. Slowing the pace down now. Quick glance at the conditions. Slots into a middle of the course position. Oh, no, here she goes up to number one. I thought they were taking the positions that they wanted to, but she slides in now. And she cannot help but be aware of those in the shooting areas next to her. A miss for Russia. A miss for Poland. Another miss for Poland. The Czech Republic. Oh, took a long time over that. Now reloads. Spear. And it is the Czechs who lead off. Jurkova. And still, Vasnetsova is in the range. The changeover is going to give David Tolar an opportunity of claiming the gold. What a lot of pressure on him. Dadukin gets ready, gets the slap from Vasnetsova, and he sets off at 11 seconds down. And he is flying after the Czech, David Tolar. David Tolar, wow, what work is going on from Dadukin. Oh, it looks from that angle as though he's closing with every stride. Tolar, Dadukin. He's taken nearly 4 seconds off that gap. He's going to go into the shooting range almost on a par. He won't be worried now. No need to fret. He's looking good. He knows that he can just rest up now. He's almost level. 45 millimeter, sort of not much more than a golf ball, I suppose, the target that they're shooting at. Ah, perfect from Tolar. He's away. He knows he's got to do it again. Works out what's going on here. And it is Dadukin. Dadukin only a fraction behind, 12 seconds in fact. This is the support they're getting. It's noisy, it's enthusiastic. The rest of the team members are on tenterhooks as David Tolar leads Alexander Dadukin into the shooting range for the last time. Standing shoot. Magazine in. loaded with five targets. They have three spears. A miss for the Russian Dedukin. Another miss for the Czech Republic. Oh, so this is becoming a situation where it's all down to skiing, and he's got problems. He's away, and Dedukin has the lead. One round left. He gets it, so no penalty lap. But it is an advantage to the Russian Federation. They celebrate already. They know that Dedukin will certainly be able to hold off David Tolar. 8 seconds the advantage. And real despair here for the Czech Republic. David Tolar, seventh in the sprint and tenth in the pursuit. But that's a long way off what Dedukin can manage. As we see Yannick enter the penalty zone. So France now, maybe another bronze medal. One to get. He gets it. They're on to the final lap in the single mixed relay. These two could not split them as they hit the shooting range for the final time. But Dedukin held his nerve better. Dedukin just not in cruise mode, but certainly aware that he's got this one. Just a 1.5 kilometer journey, no shooting at the end of it. It's just him and his skis holding it together. Being encouraged by the crowd. It might have been an early celebration after the shooting, but it was well deserved and warranted, because the Russian Federation, Valeria Vasnetsova and Alexander Dedukin, win the gold medal from the Czech Republic. Natali Yukova and David Tolar. So gold again for the Russian Federation. That's every event they've won. The Czech Republic had a chance, and France will win their second bronze of this Winter Universiade. And it's fitting that the man who will cross the line, or the person who will cross the line in the final throws of this race, and therefore the bronze medal, is Félix Cote-Puinel. France the bronze medal, a second for Cote-Puinel. And in fourth place, Poland, Mateusz Janik gave it everything. But just outside a medal here at the Winter Universiade. No nation could break the Russian Federation dominance of the biathlon again today. Thank you for watching from Krasnoyarsk.